Hello and welcome on ST Motor Control Workshop dedicated for new Motor Control Workbench version 5. Why did we decide to make Motor Control Workshop? Firstly, we have a new tool version of Motor Control Workbench, and secondly, there is many application on the market which requires such solution, as you can see on the picture. There are three main points of the workshop. Firstly, we will characterize a three-phase BLDC motor. Second point is practical, quick and easy development of motor control application. And third point is how to move smoothly from motor control evaluation to further development. It means we will teach you how to quickly move from the beginning to the final application. Here are some prerequisites of the motor control workshop. You should have laptop with Windows OS with admin rights and access to USB port. Then install our MC package. Third point is USB cable and some hardware, Nucleo F303 and X-Nucleo for motor application. BLDC motor and power supply. You will see this flowchart during all workshop sessions. We are going to fill all parts from the basic hardware setup to final motor control application. Now let's start with hardware getting started. So we will connect all boards together and test our hardware. First lap is test of used hardware with binaries and ST software, and test installed package and related software. It means testing drivers, motor control workbench, installed packages and IDEs. Now let's move to completion and connection of boards. You should have in front of you Nucleo board for motor control application, Nucleo board with STM32 microprocessor, motor, in this case it is gimbal, and power supply. On the Nucleo F303 there is also a STLink programmer for programming. Now we have all boards connected and we have to test it with binary file. You can find it in this folder. So it means C users, your username, documents, workshop, /hardware-test. You can see here hardware test binary and hardware test motor control workbench project. How to send binary to microprocessor? So you should right click on this hardware test binary, send to node F303. It means you will send this binary directly to the microprocessor. If you see blinking this LED on the STLink, it means it is programming the binary to microprocessor correctly. Here is some description what you can see in front of you. So on the STM32 Nucleo, there is a reset button, user button, which we will use for the testing, green LED for indications, and potentiometer for speed regulation. Blue button is used for start motor, stop motor, and acknowledge a fault if some fault occurs. And LED indication off means the software is in middle state, on in run state. Fast flashing, it means that fault is active now, and slow flashing is fault is over. It means that fault occurred in the past, but now it is only indication that the fault was triggered. And potentiometer for speed regulation. There is description of the testing firmware. Here you can see that the software is in middle state. You can run the motor in two ways. So first is by blue button. If you push the button, it goes to run state and motor runs. Then you can use potentiometer for speed regulation. And you can go back by the button again. Or you can use Motor Control Workbench Monitor. It means that you start the motor from the IDE and it goes to the run. You can use slider in IDE and back to the by the stop button. If some fault occurs, it goes from run to fault. Let indicate that fault is active. And if the fault is over, it goes to this state and you can acknowledge a fault by blue button. Here is another point. If you press the blue button longer than 3 seconds, it will go to pole pair test. And after 25 seconds, it goes back to idle state. So it was a binary. And now we will open the project from Motor Control Workbench. So you can find it in the Motor Control Workshop folder / hardware test, as we mentioned. Or you can open ST Motor Control Workbench and click load project. If you open Motor Control Workbench, so now we can see interface and Motor Control Workbench. So first part is a window where you can start a tuned motor, and second point you can go to monitor, which means we will play with the motor. If you are in the monitor, first point is to select COM port of USB driver and click to reconnect. If there is a green note firmware STMC SDK version something, it means that the board is connected. On the right side there are buttons for playing with motor, so start button, stop button, and fault acknowledge and select speed. So you can play with your motor in front of you, and if motor is running and everything works correctly, it is all for this part and success for this session. At the end of this session there is some notification, so as you expect, the new versions of tools are coming. It means that IDEs could have different graphic interface in the future, but don't worry, functionality and principles remain the same.